Tonight, pavement work is happening just underneath Spaceship Earth. That or they're digging in the geodesic sphere a grave. Could be that. There was a groan. Someone groaned. Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway at Hollywood Studios has a new sign at the attraction's entrance. It reads, "Please lower your expectations." We only have three shows left in the studio, and then it's on to our new home at the Vista Way Apartments. You've read WW News Today. Now it's time for WW News Tonight.
Live from Orlando, Florida, it's WDW News Tonight with Tom Corliss and Nick Lo Cicero. Tonight, the DFB Cupcake Game, Chicken Nugget Deathmatch, and a really cool unboxing video. All that and more. Now, here's your host, Tom Corliss.
Looking forward to our move to Vista Way.
Yeah, that's super pumped.
Yeah, I hope none of these are black lights. I don't know.
Maxi van goes right through there.
It's one of its preferred stops.
Yeah.
Hello, I'm Tom Corliss, and I hope you're not offended by the word penis, because it's going to be on this show a few times.
Featured word of the night.
It's anytime someone says the word penis, scream real loud. Thanks, Conky. Thanks for joining us. Please hit that like button if you aren't offended by the word penis. I'm just going to keep saying it. If you haven't, please subscribe for more genuine content and the occasional nonsense like this program.
We might have some variations on the word penis, too.
No, I don't think we can say any of the variations on that.
Okay.
I think that's the only version we can say.
Oh, okay.
I think that's the one that clears. Yeah.
I had to find out if I could say the word erect. You said yes.
Yeah, that's usually how we describe the sound on this show. How's the sound? It's a wreck. Oh, you said a wreck.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Oh, boy.
All right. And now the news.
News.
Brought to you by the WWNT Interglobe Society. After being delayed due to COVID-19, Marvel Avengers Campus will finally be opening at Disney California Adventure on June 4th, 2021. Still not open in California. Any other campus. During the A Special Look Inside Disney Parks virtual media event today, we weren't invited, surprise. Disney Parks Chairman Josh D'Amaro showcased a quote-unquote real Star Wars lightsaber for future use at the Disney parks. Bob Chapek then took the stage and shot electricity out of his hands. Profits, unlimited profits. Guests can now take maskless outdoor photos at Walt Disney World as the policy has changed. The only rule is you have to be distanced from others when you do so. Meanwhile, at SeaWorld, they've changed their policy to once again allow flash mobs. So everybody get ready. Oh, man. Disney is selling the, we talked about this already, our new home. Disney is selling the 468-unit Vista Way apartment complex located near Disney World, said the Orlando Business Journal. This dispels longstanding WW Magic Forum rumors that it will become the second phase of Disney's Art of Animation Resort. The complex is currently vacant after occupants were moved to the new Flamingo Crossings Village apartments, which opened in December and has approximately triple the number of units. The move was made after a mysterious substance began oozing from the walls. Yep. Like everything good, Bob Chapek is closing. Vista Way was built between 1988 and 1990. It features, features two pools, two clubhouses, a fitness center, and was home to Orlando's scariest attraction ever, the Vista Way sofa. Property's market value in 2020 was $63.1 million, or $63 million more than a 2020 Disney After Hours ticket. It worked because those still existed.
That's a good update on
still
that joke. I like that.
Mm-hmm. I don't think it's ever going to come back. Yeah. So you got to, you know, when it presents
Love
itself,
it.
You know. Trader Sam has been removed from the Walt Disney World Jungle Cruise and replaced with Annette. So I guess he's in that big downtown Disney rainforest cafe in the sky now. Him and Cha-Cha the Frog eating pastelaya. Some people said I was racist. This is a thing that happened on Twitter. People said I was racist for assuming that Japan will leave the character alone. Yeah. What an illogical, racist leap I made saying this is about a place where the men still chase the women and the women are still auctioned on Pirates of the Caribbean. Yep, they certainly care in Japan. They also, let's remember, they politely said they won't be changing Splash Mountain.
Right.
Yes, they definitely care about Trader Sam. Guests cruising through the greenhouses of Living with the Land can discover the history of farming, new agricultural techniques from 1982, and fruits and vegetables aplenty from around the world. However, they'll also now find scaffolding around the boat path while the ride is open. It's part of Disney's new initiative to have 50 different construction projects in each park for the world's most magical celebration. You never know where you'll find construction in rides, maybe in a restaurant, could be dining and it could be working right there, maybe even in the restroom. Happy Fittest. That is Tyler, yep. It's Tyler. Tyler, I don't know what they're doing above. Tyler's looking up at something. I don't know. She's looking at the same thing. I don't know, is this at a Kong versus Godzilla? I'm going to finish, though, said Tyler. While most guests... boy. While most guests have been happy to follow Disney's COVID-19 safety protocol, some have been more confrontational. One guest protested his arrest after he skipped the mandatory temperature screening and refused to comply with security. His rationale was if Disney can skip you past the entire Rise of the Resistance pre-show after you fought for a boarding group, he could certainly skip other vital parts of the Walt Disney World experience. It's not funny so much as it is true. It was later discovered the man received COVID relief for Coastal Bridge, a company he owns in Louisiana, despite receiving over $4.6 million from the government. Sills laid off approximately 90% of his employees and owes numerous vendors. You know, if he had led with this information, Disney management probably would have hired him instead of trespassing him. This guy sounds great. Tom Brady visited Disney's Hollywood Studios last week, and Disney had him try blue and green milk in Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. We have the clip of him trying the blue and green
milk. Blue or green?
Nick, what are you?
Brady!
You know,
blue milk! Yeah! Go Pats! I mean, Bucks, or wherever green, you are.
I thought you liked the green milk better.
Since when? Blue milk all the way. I love this stuff. Oh.
There's blue milk all over your jersey.
Oh, yes. I can't get enough of it. I drink it all the time. Love the blue milk. Always, always, it's always been blue milk. I don't know what you're talking about. Go Brady! Number one! Yeah!
We're just gonna keep it on him so he finishes it. We just want him to finish it. Brady also shared a brief exchange with Kylo Ren. Ren says, the dark side calls to you. You must make a choice. Will you join us? To which Brady replied, no thanks. Tell Belichick I'm not coming back. Wiping up your blue milk.
No.
Now?
You can even eat the blue milk with a fork. It works really well. Yeah. Anyway,
it's not Spike the Bee.
I'm always, always drinking blue milk. I don't know what you're talking about. I always have a glass of blue milk right off camera. Chugging it every. Need more of that. Yeah. Just gotta chug it from the bottle.
Disney.
It doesn't matter.
That's enough. It's dead now. Disney Cruise Line. Let the past die. Kill it if you have to. Disney Cruise Line announced that Captain Minnie Mouse will be featured on the bow of the Disney Wish cruise ship. Finally, a Disney ship that will stop and ask for directions. It's the dad joke of the week. Brought to you by Pep Boys. Meanwhile announced on for the stern of the ship, Bob Chapek's favorite Disney character, Billy the Dollar Bill. There he is. Magical. Hey, boys and girls, just fire 32,000 people. According to the Orlando Business Journal, the Walt Disney Company and Tavistock Development Company, LLC, are in talks to build residential and commercial community right in Lake Nona, Florida. Oh boy, I sure would love for more of the corporate executives from Disney to live near me. I can't wait. I'm putting a noise complaint. He's like, Bob Chapek lives next door. Sleeping Beauty Castle, he's got like a stethoscope against the wall. Sleeping Beauty Castle at Disneyland Paris is currently being refurbished like a historical monument by skilled artisans. 9 different French companies will be handling the refurbishment and have promised to treat Sleeping Beauty Castle with as much, at least as much care as Notre Dame. Nope, I knew that wasn't going to go over well. We'll move on. There they go. There goes the whole audience. Notre Dame, whatever. It doesn't matter. Shanghai Disneyland released information today. You've been there once.
I still know how to say it.
That's Notre fine. Dame.
Well, there's also the football team. So I read it how I read it. Move on.
I don't
on.
Think the French care for Notre Dame. The football
Probably not.
Team.
No, that's why they burnt it. Shanghai Disneyland released information today on surprises for their 5th anniversary, the Year of Magical Surprises. There'll be new ticket designs, as well as tons of merchandise, a new nighttime spectacular, and a meet and greet featuring Iron Man, joined by Captain America, or as he's known in Shanghai, Marvel's greatest villain. Some people are laughing way too hard at that. Concept art was released for the new Toy Story Hotel at Tokyo Disney Resort. It will open as planned in 2021 as the first moderate class hotel. This is opposed to All-Star Movies, which was the first no-class hotel. For the project, Imagineers were tasked to turn the Toy Story lands they've built for the parks into a hotel. I'd say they've done it. Thing looks particularly out of character for Tokyo, right? It doesn't look like something Tokyo will build, but I guess is how things are going to be under the new president of the Oriental Land Company, Robert Shiro Chepeku. Who brings us the news?
Are brought to you by Waits, the WDWNT Interglobe Society. Support WDWNT to get early and exclusive access to content you can't find anywhere else, including exclusive post shows for WDW News Tonight and Park Center each week, exclusive programs, detailed and ride rehab watches, access to our Discord community, and much more starting at just $2 a month. For more information, go to patreon.com/WDWNT or visit WDWNT.com and click the Patreon link. Join Wakes and help make this and other shows happen.
All right, we have a packed show for you tonight. We have the DFB Cupcake game when
Wash
we come back.
Down with blue
we
milk.
Have the, oh, are you going to save that for your chicken nuggets?
Yeah.
Because it's chicken nugget deathmatch night. We're going to find out
blue milk.
What are the best chicken nuggets in all of Orlando in the theme park realm.
Goes great with nuggets, goes great with cupcakes.
Wonderful, all the psychotic comments. We're going to open our YouTube play button tonight. A lot more coming your way tonight. Stick around.
Inch by inch, intellectual property is being thrust into Epcot, perpetuated on the fallacy that guests are being left unsatisfied by the current offerings. Now another long-standing member of the Epcot community is under threat. Recently, construction walls ensheathed a favorite rock-hard sculpture, commonly known as the Morocco Penis. It has become a lightning rod of controversy, blocked by wood. We don't know if it is being handled with care, but we here at the Epcot Erection Preservation Society want to preserve everything built around the large ball. The Morocco Penis represents how we felt for other, now lost Epcot superstructures like Horizons. Current management is intent on giving the original themes of Epcot the shaft in an attempt to stroke their own egos. We as true fans know how hard on the Epcot community this has been. We must act as a prophylactic, protecting the vision of Dick Nunes. So in that vein, we invite the community to have their voices heard. And please join us by using the hashtag save the Morocco penis. For if we lose this, it will just be the tip of things to come.
Please go to social media and tag your favorite photos with the Moroccan landmark with hashtag save the Morocco penis now, before it's prematurely removed. From Disneyland Resort President Ken Potrock, it's time for the candy every Legacy Passholder will crave.
Potrocks!
Potrocks are colorful, flavorful fun that you'll be hooked on once you get just a touch of it. Just rip open a bag and let the fun begin! Sometimes you get candy, and sometimes, well...
All I got was 30% off my next Potrocks purchase.
What a deal! Makes you forget that you didn't even get any of the candy you paid for.
Not really.
Potrocks come in 4 financially conservative flavors. Angry former pass holder, canceled pass, park still closed, and ruby grapefruit. Watch out for the angry pass holder bag. It's really bitter. Potrocks, they'll leave a bad taste in your mouth. And no, it's not a drug thing.
From the creators of Clue, Disney Parks Edition, comes an all-new version of the board game you love, themed to a park you're trying to continue loving. It's Sorry, the Epcot Edition, and whoa boy, do kids love it.
Wowie, the whole board is themed to my favorite attractions from before I was born, and whatever is left of the park.
How do we play?
It's easy. Just roll the dice, move your piece, and draw one of the event cards.
Spaceship Earth is getting redone.
All right!
With no sponsor in it, we'll be about storytelling. Sorry!
Wait, so the card says sorry? What does that mean?
It means we're... well, we're just sorry, okay? We're trying our best here.
Are you really, though? Figment is back, but Dreamfather is dead. Sorry.
Club Cool is coming back, but you have to wait for 4 years. Sorry.
There is a restaurant in space, but it only serves the Maria and Enzo's menu. Sorry.
So, how do you win?
You can't win. There is no winning.
I feel like this is about more than a board game.
Sorry, the Epcot Edition. Available at Mouse Gear and all new sterile white gift shops at Disney Parks.
WDWNT presents Timekeeping, a year-by-year journey through the history of the vacation kingdom of the world. Join us for the premiere Tuesdays at 10 p.m. Eastern or watch on demand anytime on the WDW News Today YouTube channel.
Welcome back to WDW News Tonight. We are live. Please hit that like button if you haven't yet. And let's find out what's happening this week on Disney Plus.
Action!
This week on Disney Plus, Regis Philbin in Who Wants to Be the Happiest Millionaire? That's a deep cut. That's for deep in the plus, Happiest Millionaire. Someone got it. I think it really looks like he's in it, though. It's a really good... Regis in there. I would not have known that was fake. Okay. Do we have Carousel Products?
Do we
have
that?
So Carousel Products is running a sale starting this evening. Hopefully the ad is up. I think it's up. I don't know. There it is, the spring shirt sale. Look at that. All shirts are 20% off, including our new Donde Esta maintenance shirt. But all of our shirts, any of them, all 20% off. There you go. $16 for a shirt. I think the sale is through Monday. Is that right? I don't know what it says up there.
Ends Monday at 12 a.m.
Monday at midnight. So get your shirts now. Any and all shirts we have available are just $16. Go get them right now. There you go. All right, it's time for the cupcake game. Okay.
Welcome to the DFB Cupcake Game, the game about Disney foods, good and bad, and where most of it ends up anyways, the trash. The game consists of two rounds. The question round, where you want to be the first to answer Disney food-related questions and gain a cupcake per right answer. And the throwing round, where you and your in-studio partner discuss which trash can you want to throw your cupcake in. Sink six cupcakes in six trash cans, and you will win the grand prize. Didn't accumulate enough cupcakes in round one for a chance at the grand prize? Don't worry, one secret trash can has the cupcake bonus. Throw your cupcake in the right bin and you could win. During the question round, there are two sabotage questions, which will affect the opposite team. So make sure you know your trash, I mean foods. And that's how you play the DFB cupcake game.
Yep. You doing the...
Yeah.
There you go.
Nick, how you doing?
Nick, take it away.
Yeah,
let's All play. I know is I don't do the cupcake.
The cupcake game. I'm so excited. But first, before we play the cupcake game, we've got to meet our contestants. So let's say good evening to Mark. Hello, Mark.
Not like us to not have.
Let's see if we have Jen while we're waiting for that. Jen, are you there?
They're both here,
but not.
They're here in spirit.
This never happens.
No.
Are they unmuted?
They are unmuted. I don't know if they're unmuted on their end.
There you go.
They might need to make sure they're unmuted. I don't know.
Yeah.
It seems they're unmuted on our end.
But I'm not getting a signal from either of them.
But we're getting no sound from them. That makes it really hard to play the cupcake game.
Super hard to say.
Did it again.
We could have them text in their answers.
Who are they texting? Put up
the phone number. Don't text that phone number. It doesn't get text.
We could communicate by Osprey. Send messages back and forth. Why not?
By Osprey?
Yeah, they're good. They're trained. A lot of people think it's pigeons. No, ospreys. Ospreys carry heavier, longer messages than other...
Eric? Mark says he's here. I guess.
Is he in the VMix call?
You can see.
I have his name, but I don't see anything else, and I'm not getting a signal.
Yeah. Well, this is always fun.
Let's see. Can we? You're fine there.
Are we sure they're there?
Well, their names have popped up instead of...
Okay. So they're there.
In.
You're positive they're unmuted.
There's
and the volume's turned up.
Yeah,
guys at home, Jen. I would check to make sure you're unmuted.
Okay, so Jen says she's logged in and the screen is blank.
No.
Okay, well, it's not supposed to be blank.
The screen shouldn't be blank.
No, she should see Nick.
She should see Nick,
Hi, Jen.
Call her to...
Refresh?
Yeah. Either refresh...
Yeah, I'll have them refresh.
Or
yeah, they might have just...
Recall in.
Yeah. Please bear with us at home, the fun of doing...
Can we watch the Tom Brady Blue Milk video again?
No.
Isn't this the perfect time for Spike? The bee.
No, it's not. No,
Spike
it's not.
Bee.
Don't play it. It's not. No. Nope.
Spike the bee.
Nope.
Spike the bee.
Don't you start. My father's in here chanting Spike the bee. What have you all done?
What if we sang it? What if we did like a whole
No. No. Don't do it. No.
Looks like Mark's name refreshed.
We might need to play it many times to fill the time lost on this game, though. If these people never get in the show.
We might have to play with her. Oh, wait. I see Jen. Hi, Jen.
We have somebody.
And we're getting audio from her.
Oh. Yeah, I hear Jen. All right.
Talk to Jen, Nick.
How you doing, Jen?
Good. How are you?
Fantastic now. It looks like we're halfway to a game. So, Jen, where are you calling in from tonight?
New Jersey.
New Jersey. How are things in New Jersey right about now?
They're good, but I'm coming down to Florida on Saturday, so it'll be
a lot. They're coming down to Florida.
Nice. All right. It's a place to be. Nice and warm.
Stop saying B.
I said B. Oh, wait. I did say B.
Don't be like that, Nick.
So we just need Mark to do the same thing and refresh and come back in.
Just tell Mark to log out and log back in.
He needs to sign in with video. That's the problem.
With what?
With video.
We won't put your video on there. Don't worry.
No. You're not going to be shown.
It'll make the sound work. Please come back in and enable your video.
So, Jen, do you like cupcakes?
Yes.
You did. What's your favorite cupcake you've ever had?
I feel like I'm on a first date with Nick.
I don't know. I've had one that was like chocolate filled with peanut butter. That was pretty good.
Chocolate and peanut butter.
Oh,
that is fantastic. Chocolate and peanut butter. That's a great combination.
Like this show and audio just goes together really well.
Now, Jen, have you ever, Jen, thrown a perfectly good cupcake in the trash can before ever taking a bite?
No, I don't know who would ever do that.
No, why would you do that?
You'd have to be deranged.
Ridiculous. Ridiculous. We're going to do that tonight. It's crazy. No.
No, we're not taking a bite.
No. Bite less.
It's coreless.
How are you going to review it?
You just make it up. This cupcake was good.
It's really all about the sound that it makes when it hits the bottom of the trash can.
That's how you determine the review.
Yeah. It is.
Do you want to just call him on your phone?
Yeah, I'm going to call him.
Eric's going to call him on his phone. Because that's the point we've reached with 3 weeks left in this cursed room. It's busy.
Wait, I think is he there?
Try again, Mark.
Do we have Mark now?
I have no signal.
I thought I heard something. Okay.
No. You got us all excited, Nick.
He was in chat.
Finish your blue milk. That'll keep people watching.
Done.
Drink it.
Got to sip it slow. Got to save some for the nuggets.
I know what
will keep the people watching.
Woo!
Oh, yeah. That's the stuff.
Tom, how many bees in the chat do we need before we play?
No, we're not playing the bee song.
Let's see all those bees in the chat.
His number's no good?
Eric, he said...
He gave Eric a bad number.
Because he said
yes. Usually only women do that to Eric.
He said the column.
All right.
He said in chat the column.
Oh my!
He's saying to call him. Try him again.
I'm seeing a lot of bees in the chat. I don't know what it says. No.
Please, Mark, come in so we don't have to play Spike the Bee.
Yes, those are all bees.
No!
Yes! The crowd wants
Mark the Bee.
Oh, she doesn't have it. Lauren said she doesn't have it.
You should fire her.
Blue milk.
Was he mic'd? Can people hear that? I have no idea.
They can hear Apple.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, cupcake cam.
Someone's lying. They haven't seen the Spike the Bee bit.
Oh, they haven't seen it.
No!
They haven't seen it.
No! Closed it.
She already closed it. It's gone.
I'm really, like, there's a lot of Spike the Bees in that chat.
So do we, were you trying to call him? No.
I can't reach him.
We can't reach him.
No, his number just goes.
All right.
Just play the stupid song.
Yes!
Yeah. You actually closed it? I thought you were joking.
Well, why don't we
give the people what they want.
I even said Lauren said a hilarious joke today. It's a TikTok thing.
If we have as many likes as we have bees in the chat, this is going to be...
Watch, now he's going to pick up as soon as you find Spike the Bee.
Play the 7-minute version.
There's no 7-minute version of Spike the Bee. That's the Randy Newman ad. That's 7 minutes. We could play that. That'll fill some time. Spike the Bee. We legally can't do that. We don't own Spike the Bee. It's an actual Disney character. Mike the Bee? No. No, we're not going to change it just to sell t-shirts.
How about Mike the Tree?
Pike the Bee, but it's the Fred.
I don't know. All of you are... There's something wrong with all of you.
Mike the Tree.
I just emailed him my email from my phone.
Mark, you've been emailed Eric's phone number.
This is amazing.
Please distribute it to everyone in the chat. No, I'm joking. Don't do that. Please call Eric.
And here it is.
Oh, boy.
When I find myself at Flower and Garden, looking for some food to eat, gotta get a spork with Spike the Bee. 58 pallets of unsold units standing right in front of me. Here for his fifth straight festival, Spike the Bee. Spike the Bee, Spike the Bee, Spike the Bee, Spike the Bee. Perfect for any food type, Spike the Bee. And while it's good for soup and chili, he's also perfect for poutine and Tupelo honey spoon bread, Spike the Bee. Plastic forks and spoons are wasteful, and they can't ever hope to be that versatile festival flatware, Spike the Bee. Spike the Bee, Spike the Bee, Spike the Bee, yeah, Spike the Bee. For blood orange margaritas,
margaritas.
Spike the Bee.
How do you eat that with a spork?
Spike the Bee, Spike the Bee, Spike the Bee, yeah, Spike the Bee. Disney hopes you'll finally purchase Spike the Bee.
You realize this was Mark's plan, right? He knew if he pretended not to be able to get on the line with us that we'd have to play
Spike
the Bee.
We definitely intended to put him on speakerphone and then lay a mic next to the phone.
So
you can see this on your screen, by the way.
So
by the way, that's going to blast into that microphone.
We'll find out, right? You're monitoring this. So Mark, how you doing?
Sir.
How you doing tonight, Mark?
Doing great, Nick. How are you?
Doing fantastic, Mark. It's good to have you on here. Where are you calling in from, Mark?
Chicago,
the great state of Illinois. All right, we're gonna be throwing cupcakes in trash cans. That's really the gist of it. That's the most you need to know. But the other thing you need to know is we're going to be asking a series of questions. We're so far removed from that handy-dandy instructions video. I'll have to refresh everybody on how this game is played a little bit. So we're going to ask a series of five questions. And we're going to have you kind of buzz in by shouting out your name if you know the answer to the question. And if you know the answer, if you're the first one to buzz in by yelling out your name, we're going to give you a shot to answer the question. You get it right, you get a cupcake. You get it wrong, the other person gets the chance to get a cupcake. So I want to make sure we still have Jen. Hello, Jen.
Hi.
Okay, I can hear Jen, and we got Mark, and we're ready to go.
So you don't have any more microphones. Should we need to call you on another phone?
So
it's good.
And then what will happen is you got to earn your cupcakes. You want to earn at least six because there's six trash cans to throw cupcakes into, and you want to try to get a cupcake into every trash can.
Do we
have a trash can cam?
There they are.
There's a trash can cam.
They're beautiful.
Look at that.
They don't even have decals telling you to keep your mask on.
It's got different themes there. Fantastic.
Two of them are themed to Target.
What's number five?
You spared no expense there, did you?
No, none. What is number five?
What is number five? Ace, isn't it? Pandora.
Oh, is that Ace? Okay. Yeah.
The place with the helpful hardware.
Yeah, right. Yeah. All right. So that's the gist of it. You got to answer some food-related questions. You throw cupcakes. You win prizes. It's fantastic. All right, Mark and Jen, here is question number one. What refreshing float consisting of coconut soft serve, pineapple... Mark, are you chiming in? Is it?
No.
Oh, okay. Pineapple juice and blue Curacao syrup. I knew I'd get that wrong. Because you find the Aloha Isle in the Magic Kingdom.
Oh, that's yours, Jen. I don't know.
I don't know either.
Jen, neither of you know.
They both said they don't know.
Okay. It is the, I better be careful when pronouncing this one. We're going to.
The Kinkamora.
Oh, wait.
Kinkamora flu.
Kinkamora flu.
We're going to, yes. I told you we'd have variations on the other word tonight.
See, people, you're getting your Nick pronounces things segment.
Yeah. Question number one. How dare you, Wolf? How dare you?
He picked these on purpose, didn't he? Yeah, he's like, yeah! I tried to find things with weird names.
I did not.
Love it. All right, no one gets a cupcake. Question number two. This non-soft serve snack item is now available at Sunshine Tree Terrace.
You're going to have to make these multiple choice, Nick.
You guys need to read the website.
Wow.
These are all answerable on the website.
Jen, Mark, anyone? No? No? All right, no cupcakes. What?
It's not soft serve. No.
You going to take a guess, Jen?
Is it the egg rolls?
It is not an egg roll.
You're close. You're in the vicinity.
It is a fried pork and vegetable pot sticker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Of course. Right.
How about this one? Question number three. This unusual panko-crusted blank dog was released at Downtown Disney at Disneyland Resort.
Pickle dog.
Hot dog.
Mark gets a cupcake.
There we go.
It is Pickle dog.
They're supposed to yell their names in the answer.
They are, but she was wrong, and he yelled the right name. So,
that's fair, yeah. No, so I'm gonna get it at this point.
But yeah. Yes, it'd be best if you yell your name first so I could pick who chimed in first. But Mark gets a cupcake, and so there's one for him. This year, blueberries were added to this classic Disney breakfast staple found at Disney's Hollywood Studios.
Jen, Mickey Waffles.
Jen, Mickey Waffles. That is correct. It is Mickey Waffles. You both have a cupcake. Here is question number five. How many different petite cakes from Amaret's Patisserie were available to purchase promoting Marvel Studios' WandaVision?
One.
Jen, four.
Okay. Neither of you were correct.
How many were there?
There were six.
So what, 50, 60, 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s, right?
Sure.
Jen was closer.
Jen was closer.
Give her a cupcake for that.
Give her a cupcake for that?
We're low on. We bought a lot of cupcakes. We got to throw these things.
All right, Jen, you get a cupcake. 2-1.
These people are watching to see us throw cupcakes.
All right. All right, question number six. Now, the winner of this one gets to either take a cupcake away from an opponent or add one to their total. Which Disney character is featured with their own carrot cake cupcake at Disney's Animal Kingdom just in time for spring?
I saw this. Oh, who was that?
Who was it?
Simba?
It was not Simba, Mark.
Yeti.
Was it the Yeti with his own carrot cake cupcake? No.
The Yeti with the carrot cake.
Someone much smaller and cuter. It was Thumper.
Is he in like a gardener hat? Like, just think of the Yeti. He's like, they got a rake.
That'd be amazing.
That's your next t-shirt.
The Yeti is a gardener. That's how he hurt his back. Picking those rutabagas.
Oh boy. All right. What are we going to do with all these extra cupcakes? All right.
Throw them out.
What is the name of the restaurant that will open with Remy's Ratatouille Adventure on October 1st at Epcot?
La Creperie?
La Creperie, that's a cupcake from Mark.
Right.
What is it?
Isn't it Creperie de Paris?
Yeah. Well, technically, yes.
It's La Creperie.
Oh, you can give him that one.
Please. But no, that's not right, though.
That's all right. He gave me the other cupcake.
Fine, give him the cupcake, right, whatever. He said the word crepe, it's fine.
I mean, like, come on. We're trying to give away the cupcakes.
Yeah, but don't tell... We're WDW News Today. You're going to tell people at home the wrong information? You can give them the cupcake, but tell people the truth. You're getting a little too DFB on this show. Just making things up. You won't believe.
Very. Okay.
You just call it three different names in this one post.
All right, here we go. Remember, try to yell your name first, just in case you're both ringing in at the same time, so I could pick one of you. Coinciding with the re-release of the Donald Duck annual passholder magnet, what sweet treat was available to passholders at Disney's Animal Kingdom?
Jen, the Donald Duck cupcake?
Jen, it was not a cupcake. Mark, do you ever guess on this sweet treat?
A cookie.
A cookie. It was a cookie. Mark has three cupcakes.
It was the worst cookie.
Jen has two.
Yeah, you were there.
Survived it. All right. New reusable utensils are coming soon to Disney parks. Made out of what material?
Jen bamboo.
3-3.
Good one, Jen.
All right. Here we go. Only available till April 29th, the red-crowned crane from Isle of Java at Disney's Animal Kingdom consists of frozen Coke, frozen cherry Coke, and garnished with what strawberry-flavored treat?
Mark, gummy worm?
Mark, not gummy worms. Jen?
Twizzlers?
It is not Twizzlers. It is cotton candy. Cotton candy.
Why would you need to put cherry frozen Coke and regular frozen Coke? What does that accomplish? Just for color?
That's hilarious. Okay. I'm feeling generous. We got lots of cupcakes. I'm gonna award two cupcakes to whoever gets this one right.
Oh, wow.
What is being celebrated in Rizzo's Deluxe Supreme Banquet Hall at Pizza Rizzo?
Tom's birthday party.
What did he say?
Tom's birthday party.
I mean, it looks like somewhere in the Bronx where it would have had my birthday party.
Jen, do you know?
A wedding?
It is a wedding. Two cupcakes for Jen. Jen has five cupcakes. Mark has three. We have one more question left. Now, the one who gets the correct answer on this one gets to blindfold the opponent on one cupcake throw. Pretty cool. Yeah. Lots of blindfolds tonight. You and I are going to be wearing blindfolds later.
It's Nick's kind of Thursday.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. In the banquet hall at Rizzo's.
Blue milk, blindfolds.
Love it. Tom Brady. yes.
Oh, man.
Oh, boy. I don't know if I can continue. Considered part of their Vault series, Salted Caramel Cupcake is a flavor of what at Salt and Straw at Downtown Disney District?
Jen, milkshakes?
Not milkshakes, no. No. Both wrong. Close. It's a type of milkshake. Ice cream.
This really is the DFP cupcake game. Like, in every way.
All right. So our final totals.
Get a link to milkshakes in your ice cream article.
We're about to throw cupcakes. It's time. It's getting real now. Jen, you ended up with five cupcakes. Mark, you ended up with three cupcakes. So we'll be tossing some cupcakes. Who is playing? Who's tossing cupcakes? Who's eligible?
I think the available pool is myself, yeah. Eric Morton, Allison, Axel, and is Wolf available?
Okay. Wolf available? Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So, Mark, you had less cupcakes.
Nick?
No.
Oh, no. You have to
I don't throw cupcakes.
Watch them be thrown. Okay.
I watch. I commentate.
That's fine.
Mark, who do you want throwing your cupcakes? Tom? Axel.
You're throwing cupcakes.
You're throwing cupcakes. Cool. All right. Jen, who would you like throwing your cupcakes?
Eric did really well at mini golf, and I feel like that might translate to cupcake throwing in a trash can.
All right, let's do it.
It might. Let's do it. All right.
They call cupcake throwing the mini golf of indoors. So that's,
yeah. Axel and Eric are going to line up over by the trash cans.
This friendship will be tested now.
Do we have a wide shot cupcake of the, battle? Can we go over? Do we have? What do we have?
It's not that we wore the same T-shirts on purpose.
There we go.
To the back alley cam.
All right.
This is the camera they shot Batman's parents getting killed on. I mean, this is that shot.
All right. So the way this works is you earn core bucks for getting the cupcakes in the trash cans. That's pretty simple. But here's the deal. No one can win the max all six trash cans. That's all right. But there is a trash can out there that gets you extra core bucks.
Secret trash can.
There is a secret, super special trash can with extra core bucks in it. You get that one, and oh man, you're gonna be swimming in core bucks. Let me tell you. So there is a strategy to which trash can to go for. Mark, we're gonna alternate, but you're gonna go first with Axel throwing a cupcake. So go ahead and show the trash cans. Yeah.
Be sure to Mark,
which trash can would you like to go for?
Well, since seven's not a choice, I'll have to go three.
Three, okay.
So, ma'am, this is for your birthday. So I do need to get it in three. I cannot do any other.
The goal is to get it in three. Yeah, in that's three. One you're aiming for. Yes. That's right.
Oh, you're higher.
Oh, all right. Nice job.
You won't believe what's in trash can number three.
Well done indeed. Jen, you could go for it.
They're way closer this time.
Any of the
we'll
six
play,
trash cans you'd like?
Oh, we were in the back of the room, yeah.
Let's keep this clean.
What'd she say?
Let's go with four.
All right.
Four.
Making your work for it, Eric. Oh, all right. All right, Mark, next trash can for you. Which number would you like to go through?
We gotta go for six on this one.
Yeah, all right, going all the way, go. Let's do it.
This one's far.
Oh, nice shot.
Oh yeah.
This isn't right, fun if someone doesn't two. Ruin the other right, road.
By the way, we should have told them beforehand that cupcake tossing is the national sport of Belgium.
No. By the way,
that's
just
waffle toss.
AJ, if you're watching, call me. Call me, AJ. What? Looking for a job.
Wow.
No, no, don't call AJ. Tom must not know.
Wow. All right, Jen, which number's next?
Wow.
Let's go five.
Oh! Yeah!
That counts, that's fine.
That definitely counts. All right, Mark, last cupcake.
I guess I gotta go two.
Yes, you do.
We're moving these further away next time. You know... Why is the show always 2 hours? I don't know.
Come on.
Don't hit the wall. There's no sandbags.
Oh!
Does that count?
It does not.
Where did it go? I didn't even see
into
it.
Into one.
Oh, yeah. No, that's wrong.
Oh, Axel.
That's the wrong trash. Yeah.
All right, Jen.
You're supposed to get the other one, Axel.
Jen, you have three
American
more.
American sports are confused.
Three more cupcakes. Which number's next?
All right, we'll go one first.
Yep. There you go. Oh, that was like no right. Look.
Because he's standing next to it.
All right.
Allison and I threw them across the room.
What's the only one that's left is two, right?
Well, she could go with two, three, or six.
Okay.
We'll go two and then six.
Okay.
just like forcefully straight down into the can.
I can't bring loft into this thing.
All right, here we go. Six.
This
is,
here we go.
This is the real. That's go. Where like number one was for us last time.
Oh!
Right on my backdrop.
I'm sorry, Jen.
Ooh. Okay.
All right, Jen, you got You got four cupcakes in there. Marky got two. You're both going to get $4, but let's reveal the super secret shifty trash can.
Secret.
Which one is it? Is it three? Oh, no, it's five! Oh, it's five!
All right, Jen.
Extra $4 for Jen.
There you go. We actually have a thing. Show them the thing. It looks like you're like Mega Man.
Nice. All right. Well,
congratulations.
Mark and Jen, thank you for hanging in there and playing the DFB cupcake game with us.
Who won?
Jen won.
No, Jen won.
Jen had four cupcakes in and the super secret special trash can.
There you go.
Still a happy birthday, Mark.
Happy birthday. We're going to send Mark $4 just for play.
I will send you four cupcakes that are not
Eric,
used.
Make sure Mark gets $4, please.
Yep.
There we go.
All right,
we're done with.
Should I hang up on Mark?
The wait, yeah.
Bye, Mark. Happy birthday.
Hey, thanks, guys. Take care.
Bye.
Night, Jen. Thank you.
Thanks.
Cupcakes. Game.
It was too close. They were too close to them.
Yeah, that was ridiculous.
Don't worry. The new space we have. We can really do. It's going to be super far once we move.
We're going to shoot them with t-shirt cannons.
Really far. Yeah. All right, we're going to take a commercial break. When we come back, psychotic comments. We're going to open our YouTube silver play button. That's
unboxing
exciting.
Video.
We have time for that. We still have more food to throw around with the chicken nugget deathmatch and more. Stick around for more tonight.
What the? Tell them it's a prisoner transfer. Did it work? Good. Now get a move on.
Who's been messing up everything?
It's been JPEG all along.
Who's been pulling every evil string?
It's been JPEG all along.
He's unscrupulous, full of ruthlessness.
That you haven't even noticed, and a pity is.
It's too late to fix anything now that everything has gone wrong. Thanks to JPEG, naughty JPEG.
It's been JPEG all along, and I killed the great movie ride.
What is Lunchbox? Reopen for larger crowds. What is Lunchbox? Still no tables to be found. That's right, partner. What is Lunchbox is back. Yeehaw! Now they'll make things feel normal again, quite like only two cash registers, an overcrowded mobile order pickup, and have it eat on that Rio train track out by the bathrooms. Of course, it's time for reheated Pop-Tarts. They're the very best. So eat all three and walk around with some crumbs on your chest. Yeah, we didn't even decorate this year because I sunk too much money into a barbecue restaurant in the middle of a pandemic. Pay no attention to that concrete box in Andy's backyard. But what really matters is that you open your phone, try to get that app to work, and settle in for some cold tots covered in canned beans. Are you one of those city folk vegans who wears a mask everywhere? Well, try our plant-based tots or an open quotation cheddar, closed quotation cheese sandwich. For the kids, grab a turkey sandwich or a grilled cheese, just like at school. Remember school, kids? Just walk between those extended queues for Toy Story Mania and Slinky Dog Dash. Once you go through that arch with the terrible new logo on it, you'll find yourself right here at Woody's Lunchbox. Now hurry on over. The heating lamps can only be left on for a bit to keep the electric bill low. Woody's Lunchbox. Hard to find seats around. Woody's Lunchbox. Those people are eating on the ground. Call for custodial. When a soda float gets kicked down, it's the poorest design counter service next to a bar two in town. Mini baby bell.
The accused stands before you on trial for his sins.
Forgive me. I screenshotted all of his tweets.
You only love your anonymity in a theme park. Twitter obsession.
Is that a sin?
Your life will be a great and lonely one.
Walt, forgive me.
Parody accounts are funny.
If tweeting about someone you claim to hate 5 times a day is a sin, let me be guilty.
Twitter obsession.
For men and women.
By Diz Twitter, from the makers of Buena Vista.
For men.
I am secretly in love with Tom Corliss.
Welcome back. It's time for the Disney Parks Incorrect Fact of the Week. Maybe. There it is. Trader Sam's bars at Disney properties will be turned into Trader Joe's. There you go. I'll have some cat cookies. I like those cat cookies. Nick, take it away.
Walt Disney presents...
Oh boy, Tom handed me a doozy this week when he posted a certain photo on Twitter. Let's show that right here. Here we go. Wall blocks off, back portion of Morocco Pavilion, suggestive fan favorite photo spot may finally be removed.
I didn't feel brave enough to write penis on the website.
No, you didn't. You did not.
Not in a world where everyone fights about masks. I was like, the penis is a bad idea. Let's not.
Tom, this generated a couple comments.
Just a few. Yeah.
So let's check out the first one. Steve wrote, I wonder which Disney exec saw it and felt insecure about their manhood. Safe bet their name was Bob.
Wow. Oof, I'm going to get a call about that one.
KJack248 wrote in, Morocco Pavilion erection ejection. Liam wrote in, good, that was annoying as hell and never funny.
Boo.
Thunderhammer replied, not to mention it was disrespectful to the Moroccans.
Oh, man. They did build it, that's right. The whole pavilion was built by Moroccan artisans.
If you build it, they will come.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
What? It's from Field of Dreams. It's a very famous movie quote.
Yep.
Ed wrote, Wayne Gretzky is from Morocco.
Yeah. For those who don't get this, the picture is a guy in a Wayne Gretzky jersey.
Yeah.
But also, I think some people thought we were calling Wayne Gretzky a penis.
Yeah.
I think that was part of it.
Yep.
Oh, man.
Mike wrote in, what a... Oh, I don't think I can say that one. You said I can't say that one, did you?
Which one is it?
D move.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it's on the screen already.
It's kind of there. The original orange bird wrote in, there can only be one.
That's great.
And lastly, I love this one from Jesse. I don't get it. Do people think the chimney is phallic or something? I don't see it. There you go. That's our sick out of count.
Great, thank you. So, this is a pretty cool moment. So we've been at this YouTube thing for a long time. I think we joined YouTube, really for real. I think in like June of 2012. I remember like the Cars Land videos were the first thing we really put up.
I think so.
Kind of late to YouTube. We thought maybe YouTube was a fad, which was probably a mistake in hindsight.
You posted a lot of Vine videos though.
That was late. No, but we were on Vimeo. Those of you familiar with Vimeo, Vimeo supported like 1080p. Yeah. They're like, oh, YouTube doesn't support 1080p. We're going to do Vimeo. Didn't work out very well. But all these years later, thanks to many of you watching right now, we finally made it to 100,000 subscribers on YouTube, which is great because that means you finally get this thing in the mail, which is great. I could show this because this is our P.O. box that they get stuff in for Boxed In, right? so I can show them. It's fine. Yeah, so this is what you get. And just like an episode of Boxed In, we're going to open this right now. We haven't opened it yet. It's still taped. And just like we do on Boxed In, I'm going to open it using my keys. Because this is what you do. This is what functional human beings do. You don't go to the drawer. You just grab your keys and start doing this. There we go. Is that it? Just the two? Nope. Missing one. That one. This is exhilarating. But meanwhile, there are channels with millions of subscribers who just open things.
Those are the ones with two buttons.
They have two buttons, yeah.
They have box cutters.
Yeah, Lauren was telling us her new job has two buttons. That's great. Thanks, Lauren. Okay, they're going to figure it out. This is very nicely packed.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this. You get a card. Congratulations on your subscriber milestone. We are honored to take part in recognizing your achievement and want your experience to be exceptional. This award was inspected and packaged with great care by Rick.
Thank you, Rick.
Thanks, Rick.
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 Make sure he spelled everything right before we thank him too much.
Do you remember your first subscriber? Yes, it was me. Your 100th? Yes, my mother. Your 1,000th? No, probably not. Chances are you do, and we know that you'll definitely remember your 100,000th subscriber. We have no idea who it is. Your fans may have thought, I don't. Do we know? Axel, do we know who it was?
It was somebody from the United States.
Well, that's great. Your fans have found you while searching YouTube, learned about you through a friend, or maybe you showed up as a recommended video. I doubt it. No matter how they came to your channel, put my keys away. No matter how they came to your channel, fans stayed and their numbers increased because of your unique voice and the excitement of being part of a growing community that you established.
They talk about Jason, the unique voice.
Hello. I don't like anything. You're thrilled to see the development of your community and are proud to honor your impressive milestone of reaching 100,000 subscribers with the Silver Creator Award. Congratulations. We know you have many more stories to share with your community. I feel like throwing cupcakes at the floor. We know that your fans can't wait for you to engage and amaze them even more, your commitment and creativity. So keep creating, keep building. Can't wait to see what you'll do next. And we're here to support you along the way. And maybe when you reach your million subscriber, we may write you and ask, do you remember your 100,000th subscriber? Well, thank you, the CEO of YouTube. I'm sure she actually signed this. I'm sure it's real. Did they change this? This looks different. I mean, I've always seen them in the background of people's things.
They changed it, but not recently. Recently, those have been like, this is the
oh, have they?
Before it was like a frame. This is now full silver.
It smells good.
Let me have a whiff.
There it is.
Ooh.
Woo! Angle so people can see. Oh, there you go. Now they can see it. There it is.
Push the button.
Push what?
Push the button.
Doesn't do. You know you can wipe it if you smudge it, right? How long ago did they change it? Because I remember it was like actual like a silver thing in a
Over a year. It was a silver button in a black frame, but now I mean these look nice.
I like this. Yeah, it looks good.
The second button is a gold one. We have this in the office.
So it's just this in gold then if you hit a million?
Yeah, and then diamond is 10 million.
10 million.
What is 10 million a different button?
A diamond, yeah.
A diamond?
Yes. See you all next year.
For the diamond.
Well, you know, with the move to the new studio and all the things we have planned, I think it's something to shoot for. But thank you, everyone at home. Obviously, thank you to everyone here on the team who's worked. I know this show is just a small part of our full effort on YouTube. So, but thank you, everyone, for your contributions to this, whether you work here or you're a watcher. We appreciate it. And we'll put this in a nice place in our new home when we move in a couple weeks' time. Very exciting. Cool. Is that it? Are we going to commercial now? Yep, all right. We're going to go. I'm going to repack this during the commercial break. We'll come back. We're going to eat some chicken nuggets. Stick around. Woo!
Disney's Magical Express will no longer be servicing Orlando International Airport come January 1st, 2022. What are you going to do? Take an Uber like a trash person? Are you going to take a minivan? That isn't going to exist either. Why don't you take a ride in Nick's Maxi Van? Nick's Maxi Van is proud to be the only thing in Orlando launching October 1st, 2021. Just schedule your trip online and Nick will give you his personal phone number. Hell, even if you don't schedule it, he might give it to you. Coordinate your pickup time with Nick and we'll greet you at the airport at your baggage claim. Don't worry about getting your bags. Pete ran onto the tarmac and got them for you. Once we have you and your luggage, and have successfully shaken the fuzz, it's into the Maxi Van. This tricked-out 1989 Chevrolet G20 will whisk you away in style to your $300-a-night hospital-themed room at Disney's Pop Century Resort. Inside, find a selection of assorted candies and chocolates, already open soft drinks, and inexpensive foot baths at every seat. You can also enjoy our personal entertainment center featuring DVD copies of We're Back and That Thing You Do, but not before watching a charming video preparing you for your vacation hosted by Maria of Chatter Me Disney. For a more personal experience, feel free to turn off the TV and listen to Nick's favorite water park stories. Once we arrive at your destination, we'll drop you off at the guard shack while Pete argues with security as to if a mobile food order is valid for resort parking. What convenience! So don't worry about your transportation any longer. You won't have to wait 60 minutes for a smelly bus full of tourists and hope that your luggage made it on board with Nick's Maxi Van service. Again, the only attraction in Orlando launching October 1st, 2021. Book tonight by calling 407-W-DIDNEY or online at geocities.com/NickMaxiVan257100121.
I'll be waiting for you. I'm already there. Just look outside your window.
Need to convert a building in a hurry? Call Pipes, Satellites, and Netting for your next quick venue conversion. We specialize in turning highly themed environments quickly and haphazardly into something else. Tower of Terror? With Pipes and Satellite Dishes, you're now in space! We think? Are we? Whatever, I don't know. Rainforest Cafe? With some netting, resistance poster tubes, and satellite dishes, it's a jungle resistance base on the planet Landry's. Wave hello to Cha-Cha Bings for us! It's tough to be a bug? Not anymore. With fake bricks, the exterior paneling of a circuit city, and if you were thinking satellite dishes, well, we offer antennas too, for a change of pace. Perhaps you need to turn a mountain in the Himalayas into a cartoon dragon's lair. We can do that too! We also produce static velociraptor figures if you don't believe in animatronics. Hire Pipes, Satellites, and Netting for the next project you can't complete because you have no creative people left in your organization.
Pipe, Satellites, and Netting.
This is where the early planning is taking place for our so-called Disney World project.
It is a showplace dedicated to entertain, we hope, with a purpose.
The biggest celebration Walt Disney World has ever seen. It's 50th anniversary.
Welcome back to WDW News Tonight. You're watching live, maybe. You might be watching this later. Whenever you're watching, we appreciate it. Please hit the like button, even if you're watching later. It helps us out. And let's see what's coming up on the show the next couple weeks. Our last three shows. Sorry, I've been wrong about the number all night. There's three shows left in this building. So next week, we have the old feelings discussion and also one we've been waiting to do for a long time. Draw that imaginary proprietor, where we'll pick out imaginary proprietors from Disney shops and restaurants who are not shown anywhere, and we have to draw what we think they look like.
Love it.
That's what we're doing next week. On April 22nd, it is our Animal Kingdom special for Earth Day. We're going to be playing Parks Pursuit and also a very special edition of the Liquid Magic.
Blue milk for all.
That's what you guys are drinking there, right? What's happening there. And then our final show in this studio, April 29th, Tom and Nick's Tower of Terror, in honor of Studios Week, which we celebrate each and every year. It's going to be a fun couple weeks left. We hope you'll join us for the last few shows from here on iDrive. Nick, tell us who brings us the show.
News Tonight is brought to you by the Vacationeer, the engineers of your next magical vacation. Sit back and let their team of vacation planning experts craft your family's next magical Disney trip. The best part is their services are free. Visit WDWNT.travel for details. The Vacationeer, the official travel agency of WDWNT.
Thank you, Nick. All right, we're going to take a commercial break. When we come back, it is finally time to eat some chicken nuggets. Stick around for lots of nuggets.
Inch by inch, intellectual property is being thrust into Epcot, perpetuate on the fallacy that guests are being left unsatisfied by the current offerings. Now another long-standing member of the Epcot community is under threat. Recently, construction walls ensheathed a favorite rock-hard sculpture, commonly known as the Morocco Penis. It has become a lightning rod of controversy, blocked by wood. We don't know if it is being handled with care, but we here at the Epcot Erection Preservation Society want to preserve everything built around the large ball. The Morocco Penis represents how we felt for other, now lost Epcot superstructures like Horizons. Current management is intent on giving the original themes of Epcot the shaft in an attempt to stroke their own egos. We as true fans know how hard on the Epcot community this has been. We must act as a prophylactic, protecting the vision of Dick Nunes. So in that vein, we invite the community to have their voices heard, and please join us by using the hashtag save the Morocco penis. For if we lose this, it will just be the tip of things to come.
Please go to social media and tag your favorite photos with the Moroccan landmark with hashtag save the Morocco penis now, before it's prematurely removed.
Coming this summer to theaters. Maybe. If not, it'll be streaming on something.
All right, you idiots, get in here!
Yes, Mr. Bothammer?
I need a new flesh creatures exhibit for my entirely animatronic staffed theme park, Robo Mountain. So get to Earth and steal me some animals!
But where on Earth do we get these animals from?
How about this place? Animal Kingdom Lodge.
When the animals of Animal Kingdom Lodge are kidnapped.
We animals challenge you, animatronics, to a game of basketball. If we lose, you can put us in your exhibit.
Well, yeah, but if we win, you have to leave Earth forever.
You giraffes and zebras don't even have hands. You've got 3 days to prepare.
What are we gonna do? We don't know how to play basketball. We're animals, for crying out loud.
We may not know, but all the NBA players staying at our hotel might.
The NBA season's moved to Disney World. Now we're traveling with the whole herd. Giraffes will chill, zebras will fight. Welcome to Safari Jam!
Now, the animals and the NBA players staying at Animal Kingdom Lodge Jumbo House will have to pull off the win of the century.
Bill Murray? What are you doing here?
I'm here to train you. Now let's get all you wild party animals to the NBA experience at Disney Springs.
Featuring the voices of the biggest stars in the savannah. Josh Gad, Idina Menzel, Kristen Bell, Kristen Stewart, Kristen Wiig, Christina Aguilera, and Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Safari Jam. Running wild this summer on ESPN Plus.
All right.
In an effort to streamline the theme park experience,
We at Disney are unveiling a new version of the Walt Disney World Vacation. Faster, more efficient, perfect for those with limited days off. It's Disney's Park Express service. A trackless ride vehicle will pick you up at Orlando International Airport. Just stow your luggage where we would usually put a droid. Your transport will then whisk you down I-4, past our beautifully repainted arches to the Walt Disney World Resort. Your vehicle will use a priority access lane to go through temperature checks and security before taking you inside each park. At each park, the unthemed personal conveyance holding acceptable rich guests express, or UPCHARGE for short, will skip ahead of ride vehicles at our most popular attractions, taking you through all of the park's experiences in record time.
We rode everything in the Magic Kingdom in 45 minutes. It turns out the time you actually spend on rides in a given day doesn't amount to much.
Upon arrival at your second park, the upcharge can break in half, with the front half pulling up to the urinals, while the back of the car pulls into bathroom stalls. You might want to seat the missus in the back. Then, it's a quick breeze through all three rides at Epcot. Following your second park, a Hollywood Brown Derby meal will be served on board as you travel beneath the Skyliner path to Hollywood Studios. Then, it's time for all the rides in Hollywood Studios in under 15 minutes. Sadly, the upcharge doesn't have spring action shooters for Toy Story Mania, but you can just pretend to sling webs with Tom Holland instead. Last but not least, the experience ends at Disney's Animal Kingdom, culminating in a trip on Expedition Everest. On the trip home, the upcharge will drop you off at the World of Disney store to shop, and you can grab a bite at Disney Springs.
Okay, but how do we get home?
That's your own problem. Disney's Park Express service begins at just $3,999.95 per guest. You can also upgrade to Park Express Plus, which gets you through all of the rides at double the intended speed. Walt Disney World Resort.
Money, please. Money, please.
Introducing WDWNT Entertainment, the new home for your favorite WDWNT shows, including Geekly Kingdom, a nerdy talk show with discussions, games, and interactive trivia. Deep in the Plus, diving into and reviewing the catalog available on Disney Plus. Cosmic Read Live, a show talking music, merchandise, vacation memories, and Imagineering attractions. WDWNT The RPG, a tabletop-style role-playing game like D&D but set in the parks. Ride Rehab, a satirical show of fixing attractions or ruining them even more. And many new and exciting programs to come. Subscribe now at youtube.com/WDWNTEntertainment.
What's happening this week on Nintendo Switch? What's the hot game everyone's getting? It's Lego Riviera Resort.
Oh, boy.
Hey, you had to get that pizza because all the restaurants are full due to capacity. So go to the store, grab a frozen pizza, kids. Mickey, stay at least 6 feet away from Mickey. The Lego Riviera Resort. I guess it's time. You're Nick's ready.
Chicken nuggets.
I'm surprised the napkins aren't made of foil this week. We didn't learn. I guess we learned from last week's debacle. All right, play the thing.
Chicken nuggets.
All right. I was not aware of the macaque. There's a chicken. There's a chicken on the screen. Wow. Of course, it's an anime chicken because Tyler made this.
Nah.
There it goes.
You're not wrong.
Is it from an anime? Am I right?
Probably.
Oh, okay. I thought I was. Are you doing this?
I am.
Okay. What
Hello. Welcome to the Chicken Nugget Deathmatch.
I think you could probably show them the chicken. We won't look.
Oh.
Yes, yeah, there's a chicken cam. Yeah,
it smells good in here.
Chicken cam. So we do have individual photos to show you all at home how they came when I picked them up. So we'll cut to those as well. But yeah, there's going to be 6 different chicken nuggets, chicken strips.
Are they not all nuggets?
Molded
they're
pieces not all of nuggets. Chicken-like oh, product.
Okay. They're not. Yeah, they're not all nuggets.
They're not all chickens.
They're not all chicken.
None of them are probably actually chicken.
But we picked them all up from Disney Springs. So if by any chance you guys,
Disney Springs.
They're all Disney Springs. So if you're at Disney Springs and you like chicken nuggets, listen up. We are going to tell you which chicken nuggets or chicken strips to purchase and to eat. So we have 6 different ones. We have chicken strips from Cooks
of
Dublin.
Are you telling us we're not guessing this time?
Oh, do you want
to
like guess like
how have
No, just tell us all of them.
Oh, okay.
Keep it simple.
Yeah, oh, I was like, what? Cooks of Dublin. We have Rainforest Cafe.
Oh.
We have Chef Art Smith's Homecoming. We also have Deluxe Burger, Planet Hollywood, and of course, Chicken Guy.
Chicken Guy.
Yeah. Of course, Chicken Guy.
No Splitsville. The disrespect is
no, no Splitsville.
Splitsville doesn't even have bowling alleys anymore.
they have great chicken tenders, though.
So, all right, we're gonna get to the first chicken for you all.
Ready. This mask actually is hurting my eye socket.
So the first one.
Mine is velvetly smooth in my face. Oh, I smell it. There it is.
When I came in today, the whole office just smelled like microwave chicken.
This is a long piece of chicken.
Do I have chicken? Are we eating now?
Yeah, you guys can start eating.
Okay. Are we guessing already?
No, you're giving it a number.
Well, you know, taste it a little bit.
Consistency is a bit dense. Know? It's, not the kind of mushy.
Like a frozen Tyson chicken tender. I know where it's from.
Do you taste a little bit of honey in the batter?
No, it's something else.
Oh, no.
Tom knows.
Yeah.
I know where we are. I've had this many times. It's in fairness, they're better fresh.
Yeah.
They're not amazing. They're better fresh, though.
Whatever you think here on the show.
You really don't know? I think I'm turning to him like I can see him.
No, I honestly... So
you don't know?
So if Nick doesn't know, I want Nick to go first. Nick, give us a guess of where this chicken can be. Yes, but give us a guess first.
I'm going to guess the Deluxe Burger.
All right, Deluxe.
Actually, now that I'm thinking about the place I was thinking, I don't know was in there. What are the options again?
The options are Deluxe Burger. We have Chicken Guy. Rainforest Cafe, Planet Hollywood.
Oh, yeah, okay, that one.
Okay.
I was making sure it was still there. These are the Captain Crunch, the crunch batter.
Chicken Crunch.
All right, Planet Hollywood.
Oh, is that why it's...
It's the Captain Crunch battered chicken tenders. Wow. Yeah, it's a Planet Hollywood thing.
So, Tom, from a scale from 1 to 7, what do you think? What are you going to give these?
3. They're fine.
Nick, what do you think?
So, I like the flavor a lot.
The breading's good.
But the chicken itself is low quality, so I'm also going a 3.
You're going 3 as well?
Yeah.
Don't worry, Lauren. They have a mask on. They can't yell at you.
I can hear her making mistakes.
Lauren, if anything,
I can
also
sense there's a disturbance
I'm writing
in
it
the
down,
force.
So. Yeah. If anything. All right. So... We're not going to tell you which ones are which yet. We're going to go through all the chicken. All
right.
So here comes the second chicken.
The second chicken.
I knew what that one was anyway. Oh, I hear something happening.
Oh.
Oh.
Chicken. There it is. All right.
So Tom, I'm going to give you... Ooh. I'm gonna give you a little napkin to your left.
But
that
like
second, but that first nugget
the other
on
one
there.
Felt like a
what am I doing?
Chicken stick.
That first nugget that you had, because I don't have other utensils.
What is the first one?
That one
right this? There. You're gonna put that on that napkin. Bam! You are good.
This is good. This is real chicken. This is a real piece of chicken that's breaded, not like molded and squished together.
Tom, what do you think?
It's good.
I like this one a lot. Almost like a panko breading, maybe? I don't know.
Reminds me of Publix.
Oh, yeah.
Publix has really good chicken tenders. I mean,
they do.
Yeah, yeah.
Why is Publix in this contest?
I think we had talked about putting Publix in.
It does. It's quality deli-like chicken. I know what I'm going with.
You know?
Yeah.
All right. Tom, by any chance, do you know yet?
What are the options again? I can't remember. I remember Chicken Guy.
Yep, Chicken Guy's an option. Deluxe, you have Planet Hollywood, Homecoming, Cooks of Dublin, and Rainforest Cafe.
I'm going to go Cooks of Dublin.
I'm going Homecoming.
I'm going Homecoming, Nick.
This feels like it should be.
All right.
I've never had chicken tenders at Homecoming.
And Tom, give me...
I assume it's a kid's menu thing?
They just taste the so, Art Smith and his chicken.
No, she actually...
The piece of his beard in there.
So, you asking what chicken?
Is Homecoming kid's menu?
So, Homecoming does have kid's menu, and they also have just regular entree.
They have a chicken tender entree?
Yeah, so I when I ordered, I asked for the kids' meal, and then they looked at me and they're like, you're gonna want the entree. And I was like, oh, okay, yeah, let's get the entree one.
I don't know that it's on the menu. It might just be a thing they ring in.
It might be, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
All right, so Tom, give me a number. What do you rate this?
Five.
I hate to do this early, but when you have to, you have to. I'm really going to give this a 7. This is seven. This is really, really good chicken. Like, it's like true deli-like chicken. It's not too crazy with the breading. It's true nice and light chicken. And crispy and tasty. I love it.
All right.
Is the deli considered like the home base of chicken
no.
tenders? I was going to say.
But it's real. Like, it's real. Deli, it's not like a Wendy's or McDonald's nugget. This is a real piece of chicken.
Until I came to Florida, I'd never been to a deli that had chicken tenders.
Wow. All right, guys. Let's get you that third option. Tom, I'm going to move your plate. It's going to be right in
this
front of you.
This is the weirdest Comfort Plus experience I've had on Delta. Okay.
Whoa, what's going on here?
All right.
This is interesting.
What is interesting about it?
It's flat. It's like a chicken cutlet. Like I'd layer this in a pan and put mozzarella and cheese and sauce with it.
So was Tony on
the list? Tony.
Tony's doesn't have chicken tenders. They only have chicken ruffs.
It's like a chicken chip.
A chicken chips.
You can taste cheese in the batter.
Interesting.
This is better than the last one.
No.
Am I guessing anything yet?
You guys good? You wanna, Tom? You can go first.
Chicken guy.
All right, Nick, where are you guessing?
What yeah, restaurant? It is Chicken Guy.
It's Chicken Guy?
For sure. Or let's say Chicken Dry, because it's very dry.
Oh, that's why they have all those sauces, I bet.
I think it's good.
Yeah! I got that joke blindfolded tonight. That's skill.
Nick, what are you going to rate it? From 1 to 7.
Tom thinks this is better. This is crap. This is a 3.
No, it's not. Get out of here.
This is a 3. The quality is not there. Right? That's why they give those sauces, because you need to dip them in sauces to make this any good.
You going 7?
Yep.
There we go.
Wow.
All right.
It's tender. It's juicy.
Tender and juicy. This is dry and flappy.
Flappy?
Yes.
Here we go. We got another
You're
one.
You're dry and flappy. I feel like there's chicken all over my face.
There is.
Oh, you're pretty good.
There is.
Oh, there's some weight.
There's too much
one.
Chicken in this dish now. What? Well, I don't know what I'm supposed to grab.
Oh my! What is this?
Now this is weird.
This is a whole chicken.
Is this chicken or the club?
Which ends the head?
Am I locking my car wheel with this?
Here we go.
Look it up, kids.
Doesn't even know how to eat it.
I heard that crunch.
There's so much grease.
This one is super greasy, super crunchy. Really thick batter on this one. And the batter's not tasty at all. Right?
Tough and greasy.
Mm.
Oh.
A middle name.
You guys think you have a restaurant in mind?
I would love an actual napkin I could use.
Yeah.
That'd be great. Because I just feel covered in grease after that.
Let's see. So, name the six again for me.
All right. So, we have Chicken Guy, Chef Art Smith's Homecoming. Mm-hmm. We got Deluxe Burger, Rainforest, Cooks of Dublin, Planet Hollywood.
Cooks of Dublin. This is 100% Cooks of Dublin.
You might be right. Because
it feels like the batter from the fish and chips, right? Like, so, at first I was like, oh, did you give me a fried fish, because that's what this...
You're probably right.
I think that's totally what this is.
I assume I can't answer Cooks of Dublin again now.
No, you can.
You can, just...
I'm going to steal Nick's answer, because I've never had them there. I have no idea.
All right, we'll go with Cooks with you.
This is
a
one.
One for Tom. Ooh.
It's gross.
Yeah, definitely a one.
One?
Yeah.
Wow.
I think this batter works with fish, but not with chicken.
Okay. All right, my friends, we got two left. Two left. Here's your first one. Tom, I'm going to give you another plate here.
Okay.
I'm regretting having that rotisserie chicken for lunch today.
What?
I forgot.
It's not like Nick to forget.
You were prepared for it last week.
This?
Yeah, I know.
Yep. This thing.
There's
that's,
a couple
that's
here.
The thing.
Oh, McDonald's.
This is deluxe. Can I just say that now?
Yeah, if you want to.
It's deluxe.
Yeah, because that's what, they're the only one. They have the nuggets, right?
I miss the donut breaded
one. I know, those are so good.
All right, so both of you put deluxe down.
These are solid.
Maybe it's not.
You can change it, if anything.
We've changed the texture of these things by reheating them.
Probably.
No, I'll go with deluxe. It felt like deluxe.
Same with you, Nick. You're going to keep it?
Yeah, I couldn't remember if deluxe had nuggets or, like, fries. That's why I kind of
thought
the
first
one.
They're nuggets deluxe. They're the chicken breast nuggets. Ubiquitous, as Jason would say.
Ah.
All right.
Taste a lot of butter flavor in the batter. Do you, Tom?
Yeah, it's super butter. It's a two.
Like it's an interesting batter.
It's too. More edible than the last thing for sure, but it's still bad.
Still a
a two.
Two for Tom. Nick, what do you think?
I'm going back and forth between a two or a three. I think it has to be a two.
Okay.
Yeah.
Two for you. Sounds good. All right, last one. Last one,
we
here we go.
I think we haven't had Rainforest yet, right? I haven't had... The last time I had chicken tenders at Rainforest, they were coconut.
Puzzle pieces.
It's amazing how different all these are. Ooh, this is light and small. Uh-oh, are these nuggets
too? Do I have it?
Yep, you both have it.
Oh, are these shaped like animals? Is this a crocodile? Wait, what's this one?
It's just Rainforest, guy. Yeah.
I think they are. Are they?
Are they just dinosaur chicken nuggets?
I think they are.
Lauren, how would we? We're grown men. How would we not know what dinosaur chicken nuggets feel like?
Yeah. They're totally animals.
I don't.
Oh my god, this is awful.
I don't watch any of this.
Are these vegan?
These are. Can we get things
no,
a
really.
Zero?
Like, are they?
Is
this a trick?
Technically, no.
It either tastes like cardboard or
vegan. This deserves lower than that greasy thing.
Yeah.
Ooh. Okay, we'll do it.
There was no need for actual chicken. It was
just it should have been in parentheses.
Does it get bonus points for being the closest thing we've had to a nugget?
We'll do it.
It is the closest thing to a nugget, right? We should have just called it chicken deathmatch.
The chicken deathmatch.
Those chicken nuggets more you know, marketable.
I mean, these taste the most like frozen, right?
It's because they are.
Like, yeah. That's disgusting.
When I was a kid, Rainforest had the coconut breaded one.
Oh, good. Did they not have those?
No, that was like their first menu change in their entire existence.
You
like
guys coconut
shrimp. That went away.
You are welcome to take off your blindfolds.
All right.
Oh, it's bright.
It was a dinosaur!
It's a dinosaur, yeah.
All right, let's see here.
Do not blindfold and then have studio lights in your eyes. Jeez.
Lauren, can we put up that first one for me, please? No problem. So, Tom, you thought it was Planet Hollywood. Nick, you said Deluxe. It is Planet Hollywood. Mm. Very good.
I'm going to finish that one.
So I'm going to give Tom a point there.
I love the breading.
Never had them before.
Had them?
No.
I
would have remembered that flavor.
Let's do that second one now. So our second one, you said, Tommy, you said Cooks of Dublin. Nick, you said Homecoming. Nick's getting that point. Homecoming.
Yeah. Yay. Yeah, this is very...
All right.
Makes sense that I hated it.
That third one, it's a given. Chicken guy all around right there. Point and point.
Those are easy to recognize, yeah.
Because they're flat.
Pounded flat.
That's still my favorite of the six.
Papyrus nuggets.
They're very flappy. Yeah.
they're very flappy.
Those were your favorite, Tom.
They're flappy.
Now the worst ones tonight, let's put those up.
Yeah.
Ooh, Cooks of Dublin.
They look bad.
Oh.
They look like fish and chips.
They look
right.
Bad.
Yeah, the first thing I did when I felt it, I was like, this is fish and chips.
Those fries look good.
They're so on my...
Those aren't the ones I didn't like, are they?
There's like six different fries.
Oh, all the fries are on Lauren's desk.
There's a couple there. There's a couple.
The grease from the... Look at this. The grease... Can we cut to me? The grease from the Planet Hollywood chicken nugget went through the paper towel.
No, you mean the cooks. Cooks of Dublin.
No, Cooks wasn't sitting there.
Oh.
The first nugget you moved, which was Planet Hollywood.
Oh,
that was
sitting
there. It's on the... look at the desk. The desk is shimmering. It went through the paper towel, through all the scripts, and the table is drenched.
Burning a hole in
the
floor.
I'm glad that's the one I just ate.
Oh, man.
There's chicken all over my script.
That next one we had. Yep, both of you got it. Deluxe.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
I mean, you know a Disney chicken breast nugget.
Yeah, anywhere. And then that last one. Actually,
look at that.
This was the worst one.
How much is that? What was the price?
So I'm going to go through that right now.
Okay.
All right, so Planet Hollywood costs $13.99, and it comes with a Creole mustard sauce.
No fries, though.
No fries.
No fries, because it's an appetizer type.
Correct. So that's an appetizer. Then we have the Chef Art Smith Homecoming. Ooh, my bad. If I'm not mistaken, off the top of my head, they should have been $15.99.
Oof.
$15. And that comes with two sides.
That's a lot now.
So,
where's the other side?
It was two fries.
Oh, it's two fries.
Since we weren't
going to
do sides.
That doesn't look like two fries, Art Smith.
Since we weren't going to do sides, you know, I just picked fries.
Guy's the worst.
Then Chicken Guy, I got the three tenders, and that was $5.99. And that comes just the three tenders. Does
but
not come with any
sides.
You could
do the five-tender meal for like 10?
Correct.
You get a paper cut from those things.
Right?
They're so... I love them. They're good.
The next one's Cooks of Dublin. Those are $12.45, and of course, it comes with chips. Deluxe Burger. Those are $7.99. This is a kid's meal. Mm-hmm. This one comes with... either Danimals, Danimals or fries.
All right, Wolf, where's our Danimals?
I just picked fries.
Cough up the Danimals.
So you can get Danimals or fries, carrot sticks or fries. So technically it's two sides, but you can choose, and a drink. And that was for $7.99.
That's a good deal.
That wasn't bad, yeah. And then Rainforest Cafe, their Jurassic Chicken
$48.
Tidbits. I would like to say that's what they're called. Tidbits are $10.79, and that comes with a side and a drink.
So they never said what part of the chicken it's from.
An orange.
It's from the dinosaur.
And the I just noticed I got ripped off. I did not get a drink at Rainforest Cafe.
Oh, man. Come on, Landry's.
But yeah, so.
I am a disappointed Landry Select Club member.
1, 2, 3, 4. Tom, you got 5 points. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4. Nick, you also have 5 points.
Whoa.
Everybody loses.
There's a tie.
Based on the way this dish looks, them, right? We all lost him.
But, yep.
Let's go.
Fries. Tiebreaker on the fries. Let's go. All right,
let's put the air fryer.
No. Fun story. We have to tell this story. We have time anyway. So number one, Wolf comes in Slack today, which is what we all talk on during the day. And he goes, "Does anyone have an air fryer?" A bunch of people are like, no. And then it's yours, right?
Yeah.
Of course you have an air fryer. And so Eric's like, "I have an air fryer." All right. They bring in the air fryer. They're going to warm the chicken with the air fryer. During the last commercial break, half these lights shut off, and this thing, and you've heard the other beep. The other beep has happened on the show before. This was a scary beep, a different beep that was, no, there's no power coming in at all. You're on backup power.
They start a countdown.
We start looking around the office. I'm like, I don't think we have a circuit breaker in the office. My cousin Joanne's like, you got one. She's like rummaging through the back. She's like, it's back here. Eric has to squeeze through some props and stuff we have back there. Starts flipping switches until the noise stops. And luckily it stopped. And before we